These men are my bodyguards, their lives forfeit to the guarantee of my physical safety. Of their loyalty to me there shall be no question nor doubt. I and I alone shall have the authority to stand in judgment over them. No other commander shall they have in battle, nor in service. None shall bar them from me, and none shall hamper or stall their mission. So it is decreed.
Ancient declaration made by the Emperor of Mankind during the Age of Strife. So this is my house army of custodians. Really only get seen when I have guest players over to my house who don't have an army of their own. There are two 3D printed models in here, that Grav tank, as well as the Telamon dreadnought. They make good proxies for a casual house army like this. As with all my armies, these were a speed paint, helped greatly by base coating with an airbrush and not being afraid to liberally use washes. There was no edge highlighting done in this entire army. And those bases you see, I often get asked about. I 3D modeled them and printed them, then I painted them like white marble using this tutorial. I'll throw a card on the screen. That's it. Really simple. When I first got into Warhammer 40k about 4 years ago, these models were actually the first ones I ever bought. I wanted to start with custodians, but I had an immediate pile of shame. I did not paint them and got interested in Space Marines pretty quickly. A year or two later, I finally dusted these off and finished them up. Now I really just use them in battle reports for Grimdark Future. As you can see, I like to paint to tabletop standard, perfectly fine for me from 2 feet away, and on camera after YouTube compression for a battle report, it's fine. Out front here is the unit of guard that I affectionately refer to as the Power Rangers. So instead of attaching the gems on their storm shield, I attached a unique flat-back gemstone corresponding to the color of their weapon blade, and then airbrushed in those rainbows on the shields proper. This is the Prismatic Guard. Taste the rainbow. The feet are drilled and pinned with sections of paperclip through the base. This is the only army I've done that with, but it was necessary because I didn't want any blobs of glue seeping out onto that white marble finish. And here is Captain General Valoris, flanked by two Vexilla. Quote,
"The hotter the forge, the finer the blade, or so they say. The forge of war in which we now find ourselves blazes hotter than anything the Imperium has seen in 10 millennia. We of the Adeptus Custodes were built to endure these fires. They will not be our end. Instead, we will be honed to the finest cutting edge, that we may be the bane of even the foulest heretics."